Yeah, like any meteorologist, forecasters at PG&E analyze current and past data to make predictions for the future. But while the KCRA 3 weather team focuses on how the weather may impact you, PG&E meteorologists look at how the weather may affect its lines and its workers, and by extension, its customers.
There's really an almost endless amount of use cases for meteorology and the data.
For a utility company, everything is affected by weather.
California is made up of so many microclimates.
That's where PG&E's Meteorology and Fire Science team comes in.
I have a team of 6 full-time meteorologists.
Looking at data from all over the state, and it's not just the traditional stuff.
Data science is incredibly important to our decision-making here at PG&E.
The utility's Fire Potential Index analyzes past fire incidents to predict future risk for its lines and workers.
For crews working in that area under higher fire danger, they know that they need to take certain operational mitigations.
When that risk reaches an extreme, the meteorology team communicates the need for a public safety power shutoff.
Make sure we capture the risk, make sure we don't miss any risk, and make sure that we're only using that program as a last resort for those proper situations.
Green, green, red, green.
As of 2021, PG&E is also using a quicker method to de-energize a line in just 1/10 of a second.
What we're doing with enhanced power line safety settings is we're taking that existing protection and we're speeding it up.
PG&E says the program has lowered the risk of fire caused by its equipment.
We saw a 68% reduction in the number of ignitions that occurred throughout our service territory compared with the prior 3-year average.
Between shutoffs, outages, and prevention, the utility is always trying to reach that perfect balance.
We need all parts of the equation to do our job well.
And PG&E says that now that it has installed their enhanced power line safety settings in all high-risk areas in the state, they're working on fine-tuning the technology to limit the impact of any fault-triggered outages.
Okay, so Heather, when we're talking about these public safety power shutoffs that we just experienced, what's the criteria for their forecasters for that?
Well, first and foremost, what they're looking at is the wind. That's the biggest factor this time of the year because vegetation is already dry and the air tends to be dry on any given day, too. But forecasters are looking at impacts on a circuit by circuit, and a set of lines in Colusa County may have different wind criteria compared to a set of lines in El Dorado County. So for them, it's based on the weather scenario that day and how vulnerable a specific set of lines may be. So it kind of varies situation to situation.
Very interesting. All right, Heather, thank you.